TMX students and families. Shion Mike here. I hope you're doing well. Well, we're all having a new experience with the COVID-19 and coronavirus. And in this duration, our school's going to be closed for the next couple weeks. And it is my hopes that through our online training and online conference calls, we're all going to grow in our physical fitness, in our skill sets, in our overall martial arts education. So let me explain how this is going to work for the next couple of weeks. On Tuesdays and Thursdays, we're going to have specialized online training videos that are rank specific and age specific. And on the following days, Wednesday and Friday, we're going to have online conferences that are going to be held at certain time slots. So please take a look at that email again and look at the time slot. For instance, the basic dragon class is going to begin at the 3:30 time, and that's going to go to 4:10. And then the intermediate advanced dragon time will go from 4:15 for 40 minutes. And then following that scheduling, everyone will have a chance to join in on that online conference. That as far as the students within that group and have a discussion with me, they can show me what they're doing, if they have it, and specifically any questions that they have about the video that they trained and watched the day before. And with all of that, I think we're all gonna really, really grow and share this time together. And please, if you will take video of your child or yourself training at home, in the backyard, front yard, so forth, please send it to me, and I would love to post it and let our community know what we're doing to stay energized, stay focused, stay excited, and as a means of distraction in the positive way for our community to see what we're doing in light of this serious emotional and physical situation with this virus and so forth. All being said, God bless you and your families, your health, and let's get to it. All right, students, let's get started. Hands on hips, circle your head. And the other way. Shoulder, chin to chest, lean your head back, left and right. And inner shoulder. Make sure you have soft knees, tuck and tush, back straight. Good, arms forward. Five rotations forward. And five rotations backwards. And side to side. Good. Hands on hips, circle the hips. Five rotations in each direction. And switch. One, two, three, four. Let's go back to the hand, shake them out. It's called Nishi. Nishi means to shake and loosen up. Good, some repetitions with the fingers. Squeeze, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. Shake them out, now flick them out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. Good. Spread your legs out. Lock them out. And make sure you breathe, relax, keep your knees as straight as possible. Let's go down to the left side. And extend your belly button down to your knee. Keep looking at your toes. Reach with both hands. One thing you can do is take your left hand, put it behind your calf. Take your right hand and point your toes and breathe. seconds. Bend into that knee as you come out of your stretch and move to the right leg. Reach with both hands. Now reach back with the right hand, extend your left. Breathe out. Keep your knee nice and straight. Again, hold the stretch for 6 to 10 seconds. Great job. Bring your knees in just a little bit, or bring your feet in a little bit. Place your forearms on the inside of your knees where your femoral nerve is, and allow yourself to squat down. I'm going to extend my stance a little bit more. And now, bend your rear end. Drop down in line with your knees, or below your knees. Now, push the knees out at the same time, so you get a nice stretch on the adductor muscles, which are the muscles that bring your legs together. Out. You're going to feel this tension here. It's going to be a little bit disturbing, but it's a good disturbing, it's a good stretch. So this is very helpful. So bring it down on your left knee, back straight, both hands go on the front knee, and lean forward. While looking over your right shoulder. The next stretch, go ahead and extend your front foot as far as you need to so that when you lean into it, your knee is over your ankle and both hands on that front knee. Look over that front shoulder, which in this case is your right shoulder. And get a good stretch on these obliques, the front quadricep. And switch. Same thing, look over your left shoulder. Really stretch this quad. And look back. Excellent job. Let's get into our fitness training. A lot of the day. All right, everyone. We're going to be doing four different skill sets. One is called the hollow rock, push-ups, hand release, alternate supermans, and then ultimately squats. What I'd like you to do is do 10 repetitions of each. And once you complete all four areas, I want you to do that whole set again. And keep going until the 5 minutes is up. We're going to have a timer here for you to hear the start and stop sounds. And once you're all completed, I want you to tally up how many sets you did. If, for instance, you did 3.5 sets, so you completed this 3 times, and then potentially you did 10 hollow rocks and got up to 4 hand release push-ups. So that would be 3 plus 14. 10 hollow rocks and 4 push-ups. That's how we'll keep tally of what you do on Tuesday, and then your follow-up day would be Thursday of this same walk. Okay, so have a great time. I'll put on some good music for you, and let me first show you what all the different skill sets look like. So this is a hollow rock. So a hollow rock is laying flat on your back. First, put your chin on your chest, bend your knees. Flatten your belly by pushing your center of your back to the mat. It might also be accomplished by tucking your hips slightly. With that in mind, I would like you to straighten out your legs, straighten out your arms above your head. Have your hands together pointed, have your feet together pointed. Then, lift your legs and lift your upper back. Once you're in that starting position, then start the rock. There's 10 of them that are responsible for you, and it'll look like this. Heel, hand, heel, hand. Each time you touch your heel and your hand, it's 1, 2, three, four, five. So that covers the hollow rock. The hand release push-up looks like this. I'll do it facing you. Hands need to be parallel to one another and shoulder width. Have your shoulders over the top of your hands. Your feet should be straight back together. Legs straight, suck in the belly, tuck in the tush, look 6 to 10 inches in front of you. As you go down, go all the way down, elbows rubbing your ribs. You can lay down for a split second, lift your hands up, and then push back up. You're gonna do that 10 times. Make sure your knees do not touch the ground. Eyes continue to look forward. Elbows continue to rub your ribs. Exhale on the push up. Inhale on the way down. Be sure not to drop your body on the ground. So to stay safe, not to hurt the center of your body or the lower part of your body. The next is alternate Supermans. Looks like this. Find a line to place your hands and place one foot on the outside of one of your hands. Extend that opposite leg back. It's a nice lunge position. And then switch your legs, bring the foot back up to the other hand, switch your legs, switch your legs, switch your legs. Each time you do right and left, that's considered one repetition. And I want 10. And then your basic squat is, you can start with your feet together, toes out, heels out, and then toes slightly out. The ideal position is your rear end underneath your knees, heels on the ground, eyes looking up at a 45 degree angle, shoulders over your hips. As you go down, raise your hands up in front to counterbalance, and as you come up, put your hands down. So it should look like this. Some music, have a great workout. There's going to be a stop time set on this timer, and there's going to be a sound associated with it. Plus, I'll jump in, I'll make sure you guys stop when you need to stop. Okay, let's do this thing. You guys ready? Let's do it. Go. Thank you. guys, that was it. Hope you had a good time. Hope you got your cardio up, your muscles hurt a little bit. Now, please write down those sets that you accomplished today so that on Thursday, when you're all finished with this same wad, you can compare and hopefully you were able to do more or you were able to do the same, but you're less tired. Anyways, write that down and let's get to our skill sets for today. Adult Jiu-Jitsu students, let's get going. Let's start out with our sit-up drill. Feet are gonna be double shoulders width. Hands are gonna be shoulders width. Get up on the ball of the feet. Basic sit-out is when you just kick your leg out to the side. The leg that you kick out, in this case it's the left, the right hand comes up. And then return back to your original position. Left hand is gonna come up, right leg is gonna go straight out. Always remember, if we're just gonna sit down here for a moment, make sure your hand is roughly underneath your shoulder for alignment and for stability in the shoulder. And then return. So we're gonna do 20 repetition, 10 including right and left. So let's get a workout. Ready? Left foot, right. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Excellent. Now, in Shinryu Shikai, we have an elbow series that includes 10 elbows. We're gonna work the first five, then we'll work the last five. Let's start with the left arm. Extend your right arm out. This is gonna be the surface in which you're gonna hit. Take your left arm, reach out in front. This is called a horizontal elbow. Make sure the elbow is pointing directly north. Look over your right shoulder, the same shoulder, and execute a reverse elbow, which is pretty much trigger point. Look forward and use that same elbow and rise it to the center line. If you were to open up your hand, it looks like you're brushing it. Then allow your fist to go up and drop the sending elbow. Look over your left shoulder in this case, grab with your right hand, step with your left, drag with the right, and do a left elbow strike. That's 1 through 5. Let's try it on the right side. Right elbow, left palm. Right reverse elbow. Right ascending elbow. Right drop in elbow. Step and slide. Right side elbow. Here we go. Left side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right side. Ish. Me. Sun. Chi. Go. Left side. Ish. Me. Sun. Chi. Go. And left side. Ish. Me. Sun. Chi. Go. Now let's work the 6 through 10. With the left arm, if somebody was grabbing your shoulder, you would push their arm off. Your striking elbow is going to come down at a 45-degree angle while you're stepping back with your left foot. Step forward with your left leg and do just the opposite. A 45 left slicing elbow. Allow your right hand to come up as a guard hand. From here, take your left hand, extend it up, and drive forward as you step and slide. Again, your hand, if it was open, it looks like you can brush your hair. It looks like you can attach to your shoulder, to your head, which makes a good triangular block. And from there, number 9, it's just an inverted side elbow. This can be used to deflect kicks, possible punches. It can be used as an entry to somebody coming in for you. They're shooting for your legs. You control their head and you get your guillotine, cinch that up. You can go into a Ushiro Hikome, where you just hook that arm, hook that head, hook the arm, step back, but it's an entry for that. So, let's do the other side. Step back with your right, right, descending 45 angle. And forward, slicing 45 angle. Reach out, drive that elbow. Drop the fist, inverted elbow, and then from here, rising. So here we go. Left side, back, forward, drive, inverted elbow, rising elbow. Right side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Other side. We're working the whole series now, as you can see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Other side. Pitch. Three. Sign. Chi. Go. Look. Teach. Hatch. Cool. Jewel. All right, so now, in Shibuyoshi Dai, we also have a series of 5 knees. These are great drills, good just strengthening the legs, and have some fun. Once I'm done doing the repetitions, shut the camera off and do more of all of these series. The kick out series, the sit out series, the elbow series, and then now the knee series that I'm gonna show you. Okay, so number one, it's just a rising knee. Go ahead and cup your hands like you have somebody's head and neck, and just alternate the legs, bring your left leg knee up, about chest level. Keep your hands here rather than bringing your hands, bring your knee up to your hands. And then switch, then switch, then switch, then switch. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Next thing we're gonna do, it's called a diagonal knee. And I want there to be some movement with the hands, as if you have a neck and you possibly have that inside cupping of the bicep, okay? Just that, those two handles, all right? So go ahead and put your left leg in back, hook the neck, hook the bicep, and bring that knee through those hands so there's a push and pull action. So watch. Now switch, put your right leg in back. Your right hand high, left hand here, cupping the bicep, and now switch. Now switch. Now notice what I'm doing. The knee that I'm striking with, I'm putting it down and I'm pulling my left leg back. And now I'm setting it up for that next knee. Now I'm putting that down pretty much neutral with this leg and pulling this leg back to set up for this next reverse knee. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. So the next one, a dropping knee. So get yourself set up. Again, this is just a drill. Drill for the skill. And so get yourself set up in almost like a Hibachi, maybe a little bit wider. Get your hands up in front of you, tighten your fists in front of your shoulders. Now I want you to take your left knee and just drop it. If your feet are set up initially in the correct position, when you drop, this should be a nice lunge. Knee in line with hip, foot in line with knee. And then from there, you should be able to pivot back to the heel of your left foot and have neutral position. So I'm gonna drop my right knee, but my right hand's gonna be in front. Now I'm gonna come center. My left knee's dropping, my left hand comes in front, and then I come center. And one, two, keep your posture. Three, see, shoulders over hips. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Good, so that's number three. Number four, we are gonna do driving knee. Now do it at different angles so you can see, the dynamics of the pendulum action of the hips. So from the front, I'm going to start with my right leg in front, left leg in back, hands are up. My knee is going to come up about belt height, waist height. And then there's going to be a pendulum action in the hips, and you're going to see, from the camera's point of view, the knee should get a little bit closer. Not so much 3D, but so don't feel like you have to flinch. Watch. And then back. Now my right leg's in the back. Same thing. It's going to come up, shift, and then back. And then back. And then back. Let's do five more. One, back, two, it's important to work this footwork, three, four, focusing, keeping my hands up, five. Now I'm going to do it from the side so you can see. I'm going to start with my left leg in front, one, two, three. Four, five, good. And last one, you'll see this in Muay Thai. It happens when two fighters, they clinch. They'll have an over-under, and they'll look to strike each other's liver, spleen, kidneys, if they're far enough back. It's a great little exercise to do. Also a great way to redirect kicks coming at you. Redirect kicks here, setting them up with different technique series that we teach here, and they teach elsewhere too. So let's take a look. Ready? Hands are gonna be here. You can have them up here like a Muay Thai fighter, but we're gonna start with the left leg. I need the knee to come on and up on the outside, cross center line, and then go right back out and then down. Knee comes up, cross the center line, and then come straight back down. Ready? Nice and slow, but with breath. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. 8, 9, 10. Let's do that one again. Good, okay? So when you're practicing and you feel a little off on a technique, do it again. Do it 10, do it 20 times, okay? Feel free to play this video over 2 or 3 times until you feel good about it. And then go ahead and do what you want to do. Have a good time. Stay safe, stay healthy. Have a great night.